Thank you. Thank you all for having me today, for being here. President Myskins, Rabbi Shore, members of the Queens College community, usually when I come to these things, I try to figure out what I'm going to say. Obviously, you try to do that. But how can you synthesize all of the events? How can you say something profound? How can you give some meaning to the terrible events of 9/11? Certainly 9/11 represents the worst in humanity and the best in humanity at the same time. And I think it was the collision of the best and the worst in mankind that you have this quandary, the worst possible evil being perpetrated, the greatest possible sacrifice on the thousands who perished, on the hundreds of responders who selflessly ran into the building. So certainly there is a war going on. A war going on between light and dark, between good and evil, that played out on that fateful day, that plays out in our hearts each and every day. Isn't that the case? And when you think of coming to an event like this, or and you say, okay, what we want to commemorate, we want to do something. We want to honor those who were lost in some special way. And for me, I think the best way to honor those that were lost is that in the struggle between good and evil, it goes on in each and every one of us. Try to be a little better person today, in whatever way, large or small. Each of us take a step in the right direction in our own hearts today. And I think that would be a fitting tribute to the people who gave their lives, the people who were lost. And by no means can we go the other way and let the events of 9/11 make us less of a people. Because if the takeaway from 9/11 is that we're going to use that as an opportunity to scapegoat people, to profile people, to harbor things in our hearts that are based out of hatred, then that means that some of the towers fell on you. And we can't allow that to happen. Those towers coming down are not going to destroy what America is, what the truly unique country that we are. There's never been a country like this, that people from all nationalities, all creeds, all everything imaginable come together in this melting pot and live together in peace and freedom. There's never been another country like that. To the extent that we allow the events of 9/11 to in any way, shape, or form chip away in our own hearts and lead us to harbor thoughts and feelings and things that are things that don't represent the better side of our nature, then we are victims of 9/11 too. So I think we honor the victims of 9/11 by not becoming victims of 9/11, by not falling prey to the hatred and to the nonsense. I want to remember in a special way George Howard. You might have seen President Bush hold up the badge. He was a Port Authority cop. He was in my homeroom in Shawnut High School. He was a great guy. He was a good lacrosse player. He taught lacrosse at a local high school. And when he heard the events play out on the radio that day, he turned his car toward the Twin Towers. do what he could do, and he was parished, and he was my friend, and I remember him in a very, very special way today. Thank you all very much for having me. God bless you all.